DNA is a molecule that encodes the genetic instructions of an organism, and it is unique to each species. DNA barcoding is a method that uses an organism's DNA to identify it as belonging to a certain species. In Canada, our scientists are at the leading edge of DNA barcoding. At Agriculture and Agri-Food Canada, we have been identifying thousands of good and bad organisms and registering their DNA barcodes to international databanks. The benefits of this work and DNA barcoding are huge for our agricultural crops, livestock, and trade.
In mycology, and there are many cases where the organism would look the same in culture, they would look the same under the microscope, and we do need DNA sequencing to figure out if they're different species or not. Most Canadians would not realize it, but identifying organism is part of daily life. Well, you go to the supermarket, you want to make sure there's no pathogens in there, we did not import the plant quarantine organism with the food we're eating. So it is part of the daily life, and we don't see it.
With the Canadian Food Inspection Agency, we explore state-of-the-art technologies such as next-generation sequencing and metagenomics for the detection of pathogens in cereals and other grains. Accurate and reliable identifications of these microorganisms is paramount. DNA barcode data sets support the information provided on phytosanitary certificates and statements of assurance for grain shipments. These certificates and statements secure free market access for Canadian grain exports worth billions of dollars every year.
The challenges that DNA barcoding can resolve are really numerous. For my lab and our group here, we're really focusing on quarantine species, invasive species. One of these organisms can really cause hundreds of millions of dollars in trade disruption. So we're really trying to prevent the introduction. And we're also trying to develop tools to make sure that what we export is clean.
A recent example that comes to mind where DNA barcoding played an important role was a shipment of pulses to South America. By linking newly acquired DNA baseline data with specimen and other historical information, we were able to quickly confirm the absence of the pathogen in Canada, assuring compliance of the multi-million dollar cargo.
The future is very promising for this kind of technology. The technology now is such that we're making it more available and easier to use by a wider range of people.